What's up? What's up? It's your boy SneakerQue checking in with Mott Magazine. I got three special guests coming through. It's in the building today.
This is
gentlemen of
Swagu Style House. Oh, baby. Do you want me? Do you need me? Do you have somebody else? Do you at least give me a little FaceTime? Tell me go fuck myself. This is Deep.
My name is Medulla.
I go by the name of Stranger.
What's up, fellas, man? You know, it's a pleasure. All right, so let's jump into it. You guys are a group, consist of two of you guys are from Atlanta, Georgia. One of you guys was born in Germany, correct?
Correct.
How did the group originate?
Well, all of our families knew each other, so we all knew each other from very early childhood. We actually all from Atlanta.
Okay.
I was actually born in Boston.
Oh, Boston. Oh, yeah. I spent a lot of summers in Boston.
I was raised in Atlanta. Okay. So I take that as my home. You know, all my family's from Georgia all over. So
you're a Georgia boy.
Georgia boy at heart. I can't really just claim Atlanta by itself. So from the south, southwest, everywhere. But
Fayetteville, Georgia.
Fayetteville, south side.
Fayetteville, south side. South side, that's me.
Yeah, I go by the name of Stranger. Yeah, I'm actually the one from Germany.
Okay.
I was born in Germany.
Okay.
I was actually family in the military.
Gotcha.
Stuff like that. So
that's what's up. So what genre do you guys consider yourself? Are you guys a singer group, singing rap slash trio? Like, what genre would you guys put yourself in? If you wanted to put yourself in a box.
Okay. I could say if we wanted to put ourselves in a box, it would have to be like alternative hip hop.
Okay.
But you know, it's other elements in there like rock, you know what I'm saying? Like trying to showcase everything in one song is kind of hard to do, you know what I'm saying? So
definitely.
I guess the more music that comes out, we will be categorizing at some point. But as far as now, it's definitely like alternative hip hop for us.
Definitely, definitely, definitely.
I would like to say we want to start off with whatever genre makes the most revenue. So we would consider ourselves as pop artists, pop hip hop artists. As well as what Stranger said, this is deep, you know, because once you go hip hop, it's hard to cross over into pop. But if you start off as pop, you can always make a hip hop song. And I mean, we come from hip hop, so I mean, we're not gonna not show hip hop any love in our music, you know what I'm saying? So
dope. You got something to say?
My name is Medulla, by the way.
Okay.
You know, I feel like once we reach, you know, the amount of people we really want to reach with our music, I feel like the sound is gonna evolve into something that's truly, like, you know, undescribable, but something that's, you know, genuine to us, something that, you know, we created alone, you know, but, you know, inspired, you know, greats, of course.
So where does, you know, I guess, like, some of the influences come from? Like, who are some of the influences, you know, you guys growing up, music influences?
Shoot, you know, we always listen to different types of music. I know Souls of Mischief was one of our heavy inspirations. But, you know, we were always, you know, in different types of music, you know, so System of a Down was okay. Always a heavy inspiration.
I always like old school music, like James Brown and Prince and the Hi-O Players and just like...
That was acting like y'all old or something.
Collins.
Golly.
I love Bootsy Collins and Parliament. We met George Clinton at the Afro Punk Festival.
Shout out to George Clinton. Shout out to George Clinton.
That was so dope, man. You know, not just knee deep, got me totally deep when I do the freak with me. You know?
You got some old souls in the building, I see.
Definitely some influence for us, like Devo, Cameo. But definitely like the new school, because we grew up in the new school, so we can name off everybody in the new school because we love that too. But like some stuff like our generation don't know about, like groups that we named, you know what I'm saying?
Definitely.
But like they know about them, you know what I'm saying? Like you can just do a YouTube search, but you know, I guess we just shine in the light because you know that's the kind of music that we kind of look up to, you
gotcha.
Know, as far as what we're doing.
So, how do you guys get in contact? You know, how do you garner the attention from someone like CeeLo Green? How did that come about?
Well, like I said, all our family knew each other. So,
okay.
He was always, you know, around, we always did music, you know, low key, you know, without presenting it to him. So, cause we was just trying to strive on our own merit, you know
yeah,
what I'm saying? So, but it was getting so much attention. It actually, you know, he actually caught wind of it and was like, yeah, okay, I'm just going to go ahead and scoop you guys up,
cause
that's how it all
has that always been, like, you know, a mission, you know, like, you know, you guys do music like But some people say, oh, we just do it for fun. You know, ironically, some people say they do music for fun. Some people say, oh, we know we want to stay independent. There has always been like a goal of you guys to, you know, garner attention from someone, you know, who has ties with Epic Records and stuff like that. Has it always been like a goal of you guys to get signed and stuff like that?
Oh yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. We do this with one goal in mind, and that's to, you know, definitely get our word out there. Yeah. But, you know, we want to do this as a career choice. Gotcha. As well. You know what, gotcha, I'm saying? And that comes with, you know, with the territory comes with making money. You know what I'm saying? So definitely want to get our message out there. And, you know, with that being said, the money's going to come as well. So I know that's
right. Yeah, right. That's right.
I agree. This is deep. I agree with what Stranger said. I think we've always strived to be like the top artist on a major label, you know, bringing in that them platinum, and just like Outkast having like a diamond record, you know.
Okay, 10 million. Yeah, songs, definitely.
You know, like, that's a big goal to strive for, you know, and we always want to strive for the best, you know, and platform catapult off of that. You know, you see people before you doing it, we're a younger generation, so why not, you know, exceed that, what they've already done.
Yeah. So take me through the name. Like, how did you guys come up with the name?
Style in general. Like, we all have very eclectic style. Like, just the way we think, you know, the way we dress, you know. We all athletic, you know, like, we competitors. So just being, you know, trying to have swag in everything we do, you know, it's a house of style, you know. So it's a Swagu style house. It just came about just people like, man, y'all always, every time I see y'all, y'all got swag, you know what I'm saying? People like, y'all got style, you know, like, we want to come to y'all house. What y'all doing at y'all house? Why y'all like that? So, I mean, that's just like a... It's like, in general, you know, that's just how I feel about it. People always just gravitate towards us. You know, we always humble people, you know, not arrogant, but we still, you know, hold ourselves with, like, high confidence and high regard, like,
dope,
great moral
dope
values.
Dope, dope. Hey, you got to have that in this industry, man. They'll wash you away. You good? Yeah. Don't be quiet over there, man. Don't be quiet. So, you know, obviously you guys have stated that you want, you know, the ultimate goal is you want to be, like, top artists on the top label and some things. What are some of the things that you guys have noticed since you've, you know, been signed that has changed? Like, you know what I'm saying? Obviously, you guys are doing media days now, and, you know, how's that, you know, how's that come up? You know, how does that make you guys feel? You know, I know it makes, like, you closer to what you wanted to be.
Definitely closer to our life goals. You know, I know it's something that collectively we've all wanted to do since basically we were born. You know, it makes you feel very highly favored and blessed, you know, that you have the opportunity to really experience something like that, because a lot of people, especially in Atlanta, a lot of people don't really get to experience what, you know, we just going through every day now. So it's some positive, it's something great, you know.
I was going to say, yeah, life has definitely changed. You know, we got that $1 million check. No, I'm just playing. I was about to say,
let me borrow something, man.
I'm just joking. No, but it's a beautiful process. You know, we love the process. And that was one of the goals, you know, a short-term goal and long-term goal is to, you know, get attention from major labels, big industry names, you know what I'm saying, and get our name out there. So it's definitely changing, and the growth is definitely phenomenal. Right, so I can see it.
So you guys, you know, you got the song, the iPhone song.
Mm-hmm.
How's that going for you guys? Like, you know, you getting good feedback from that?
Yeah. Everybody seems to love it. Pick it up.
It's dope.
Yeah, it's definitely a different record. And I hope, you know, by putting that out, it you know, people will categorize it, you know, and just see. And keep their mind open when they're hearing it. You know what I'm saying? It's a concept record. It's more lyrical. You know what I'm saying? And it's for the ladies.
You gotta have the best way to get into the game is get the hardest of the ladies, man. You know, that's to be true. So new music. What other new music you guys working on?
Right now, we got a mixtape that we're working on. We got in the works. Well, we actually done with it. It's called Shazam. It's inspired by just going out to different places and like restaurants, being in an elevator, sitting in the doctor's office or something. You hear a nice jam, you Shazam it, and then you want to just, you know, put some music over it. So
I just got put onto that whole thing about a few months back.
Shazam or something?
Yeah, and I was like, what is that? And then it was like, yo, whatever music come on, you can Shazam, and they'll tell you what it is if you don't, if you're not familiar with who did the song.
People don't know it's actually tied into Siri, so you can ask Siri what song is this, and Shazam will find it for you. So you don't even have to have the app. Shazam will find it for you through Siri.
How cool is that, man?
So hopefully, you know, you type in, you be like, Swagu, and then Siri be like, oh, check out this new Shazam mixtape from Swagu Style House.
That's dope. Any collabs on there?
No, it's all us. Y'all. You know, we got Medulla, all bass guitar on every song we did on there. We got a lot of good skits on there, keeping it, you know, funny, and then, you know, great music, all different types of genre music on there. Like,
so what's the plans for the summer? Well, obviously the summer is the ending, but going into the fall and the new year, like, you know, tours, you know, what are some of the other things you guys have in place?
Definitely just promoting the single. We're pushing this. We'll be putting out the Shazam, and I don't think we have any show dates coming up yet. But stay tuned. Everybody can just follow us on This Is Swagu, and just, you know, keep locked in, and we'll definitely give you all the tour updates and stuff like that.
It's dope, man.
Yeah.
Shoot, man, I wish you guys the best of luck, man. Like I said, I listened to the tracks that were sent over to me. You know, you guys have a unique sound, unique style, and I think that those are some key things needed to garner attention from, you know, people, because people like different. People don't like the same, and you guys are somewhat different, you know, in your style and, you know, your music as well. You know, nobody likes things to stay the same. So before we get out here, I want you guys, you know, drop all your personal Instagram, Twitter, Snapchat, and as well as the group social media handles.
Okay. Well, this is Swagu Style House. I go by the name of Stranger. Got my brother to the right. His name is Deep. Got my other brother. He's the multi-instrumentalist of the group. His name is Medulla. All our social media, y'all can follow us. This is Swagu, and Swagu is spelled Swagu.
So where these nicknames come from, though? Like, Stranger and the Medulla, like, those aren't your government names, man.
Absolutely.
They are?
Absolutely.
So Stranger is your government? No, okay, I was about to say, like, don't fool me, man. Golly, I'm like, yo, those ain't y'all names, though, man. So where did it come about? Like, how did that come about?
Stranger, my name just came about by just completely doing the opposite thing on purpose. Just being that guy. And my brother just always called me Strange, aka Stranger. So I got
dope.
My name.
Dope.
Well, I got Deep because every time I have a rebuttal to something, people say, man, that was too deep. Like, you in a whole nother playing field than what I was talking about. Like, so it's like they just call me Deep Pockets, Deep Thought, Deep Diver, you know, Deep 6 feet deep, you know, like, I just like deep about everything. Like, I really like to get into the conscious mind and like dissect it and give something that make people think.
That's what's up.
The medulla is actually a part of the brain that's located, you know, in the back of the brain that controls involuntary things like the heartbeat and, you know, breathing. So basically, I stay in the back of your mind and you can't survive without me.
Hey, that's deep.
Hey, that's deep, right?
That's pretty deep right there, man. That's pretty deep. That's strange. Yeah, deep and strange. Deep and strange, man. But look, man, it was a pleasure, man. Best of luck to you guys.
Likewise. We appreciate you having us.
I'm going to be checking you out, you know.
We got some precursor Swagu music on the SoundCloud as well. So
yeah, you know. Drop the SoundCloud too. You drop the SoundCloud?
Yeah, the SoundCloud is Hello Swagu.
Definitely, man. Best of luck to you guys. It's your boy SneakerQue, Mop Magazine, our artist spotlight. Homie Swagu. Okay. Until next time, peace.